You should have saw it earlier. She had her paw, like, right here. She was just cuddling my face. Get my. What are you doing? I can't just sleep. Hi, everybody. How you doing? She's staring at me, and it's kind of hard to focus. What are you doing?
Yeah. Now there's fluff all over my face.
What's going on? It's everywhere. You're shedding all over me, John Belly. She's like right there. You're like right there, Johnny Belly.
Oh,
that was cute, except you just like.
Help.
What are you doing? What's going on? Are you done? So apparently. Laying with her face towards my face was too much, because now she decided to turn around, and now she's laying the other way. So now I've got her booty in my face. Let's see
how it is.
Really?
You just sit in your way and we don't wake up. It's like you knew. Gotta go to work. No. No. Pants on. Yeah. Look away for a second. I gotta get my pants on. and Holly and Barry.
People are thinking right now. Like,
Earl, wait, did
you go back to Wally World and, yeah, I did. And then now you're all thinking,
why did you go back to Wally World? You just had that whole spiel.
Was that the last update? Like, 2 updates ago, and then you had the one in June? Was it June or July? And you had that one update about quitting your job, where you ranted about how much you hated it and whatnot.
Why did you go back?
Well, I'm trying to think of the answer. Let's see. Babies R Us was cool. I'm working on Babies R Us right now. I still am. I just had orientation today. So technically I'm working at Wally World and Babies R Us right now. Same time. But I already put on my 2 weeks. Now why would I leave Babies R Us? I was so excited about going to it. It wasn't what I thought it was going to be. Things change. Things can change. Just because I said it was awesome in the beginning doesn't mean it's awesome now. Things can change. And, just in the month I was there, just... I like the people. Here's the problem. Now, here's the contradiction between both. Babies R Us, I like the people. But the job, even though it's stocking. Stocking is easy. Half the time I wasn't stocking. I was on the register. And you know how I am. At Walmart, they would put me on the door to cover the door greeter's lunch or break. I'm not a door greeter, I'm a cart pusher. The reason why I'm outside pushing carts is because I don't want to be inside with the people. So you put me on the door, surrounded by the people. You put me on the register, surrounded by the people. I hated that. Now, Babies R Us, I like the people, but I hate the job. At Wally World, I like the job. I didn't say I hated carts. The only reason why I quit is because it almost killed me. Now you're probably thinking, oh wait, if it almost killed you, why are you going back? I'll get to that in a second, but still. At Wally World, I like the job, but I hated the people. Now, here's the thing. I didn't hate the people. They weren't nice. The customers. We had the rude customers, and then the managers. But here as of late, like I talked about in the updates a little bit ago, somebody got fired. A certain store manager got fired. Now see, I wouldn't have had my job at Babies R Us. It wouldn't have happened because I filled out a Wally World first because I wanted to go back. Because I liked the job. And because it paid well. Being at Babies R Us, I was only making $7.25. And once you like at $9 and then you go down to $7.25 in only 20 hours instead of full time at $9, you go down to $7.25 at 20 hours, you're like, this is barely any money. After you're used to being $9 at 40 hours, it's like, oh, money. So, yes, I needed money because that's basically what fueled it. It's because I need money. I'm starting college here pretty soon. And I need a car. And my last 2 paychecks from Babies R Us were only $2.50. That's it. Just $250. So that's $500 in the time that I worked there. At Wally World, my paychecks were $500 every 2 weeks. That's $1,000. I'm not really going to be full-time. I'm going to be part-time. But hopefully go up to full-time. But then I'm going to have to go back down to part-time because, like I said, I'm going to school. That means that I can only work 20 hours. So later on down the road, I'm going to have to change my schedule. Which, boom, I'm not going to be working as much. Which means, boom, I'm not going to get hurt again. Plus, we have a bunch more cart people, so I actually won't be alone all the time. So, I need a car. And I need a car before I start in August, because I gotta get to school. So going to Wally World, making more money, I'll get the car faster. And then all the people who were snappy are all gone. They either transferred to a different store or got fired. Everybody that's left is all the people that I didn't have a beef with. So. So that happened, so. Pretty much just explained myself right there. I need more money. And I talked to all the people at Babies for Us that I was like, hey, I'm gonna have to quit because, and but I'm sad, I'm gonna have to, I'm putting in my 2 weeks. I'm quitting in 2 weeks. And they were like, oh no, why? And I was like, I'm not making enough money. And every manager I talked to and every employee I talked to were just like, oh, that's reasonable. Like, they were totally cool with it, because they understand. They've been down that road where money makes a world around. Like, even though you're not supposed to love the money, but you need money in order to get through life. And only getting $250, and half of that, well, that would be $500 a month, half of that goes to the parents, and then I got bills to pay. I still have that medical bill that I gotta pay on. And then school, but hopefully school will be all paid off. But it's just, I need more money. And they understood. They were totally cool with it. So I'm not just like, totally bumming them out. They're just, I don't want this. I need more money. I was like almost in tears because I didn't want to leave. Because I liked the people. That's the only reason why. I didn't want to hurt the people there because the people there were cool. To everybody in the family, and they all understood. Almost all of them understood. You got it. You just got it.
That's it. That's really it. I'm going back to push carts at Wally World.
Gonna be outside. Get to see a beautiful sunrise if I come in the morning, you get to see a beautiful sunset if I work in the evenings. Get to do nothing but push carts, don't have to worry about going on a register, don't have to worry about even registering. Cause that's worse than being on the door. I lost my mind. When I go back to Wally World too, I'm gonna tell them.
I'm not going on the door. It's not gonna happen.
There's two other car people.
Go get them. I'm not going on that door.
Even if my own mother's on the door, which she is. Even if my own mom's on the door.
I'm not going on the door.
Get the bounce. Because I absolutely lose my mind.
I don't do well around people. I don't. That's why I'm outside in the parking lot.
I can go and hide in between a car and
just.
I surprised so many people just by sneaking up on them. Like when they got all the groceries in the car and they're gonna put the cart away, I just randomly pop up there, oh, I'll take your cart, and they're like, ah! It's just so much fun. coming back. And, some people might not like it. Some people might be just fine with it. I don't really care. I made this decision for me. It's just me. It's just my decision.
If I didn't want to go, I wouldn't have gone. Going back into the mess. But I have better knowledge about what happened. So hopefully nothing bad will happen. That's all I have to say. How do you feel about it, Johnny Manny? Okay. That's it. I don't know what else to say. I
kind of just like rambled. Hopefully I said everything I wanted to say. I liked Babies R Us. I liked the people. But I hated the job. While I rolled, I liked the job. But I hated the people. But all the people that I didn't like are all gone. And I would have been back. Did you get on that? Yeah, I kind of did. I said I would have been. I kind of got off subject. I would have been at Wally World before, but then I got on to talking about why I didn't like the people. I would have been there. I would have got hired at Wally World back in March when I got hired to leave the rest. But a certain store manager wouldn't let me come back. Let everybody else come back, but he wouldn't let me come back. And then all of a sudden, once he's gone, they asked my mom, because my mom still worked there, they asked if I was still trying to apply. And she said, yeah. And they were like, okay, we'll try to get him in. And boom, all of a sudden, I'm here. So weird how he leaves, and all of a sudden, I'm able to come back now. Yeah, I've been trying to come back for 3 months. And all of a sudden, once he's gone, whoop, I'm back. That's strange. It's very strange.
That's it. That's it. I'm done. I've said what I wanted to say.
Some people might not like it.
And, sorry. After all this, you're going back. Why did you even quit in the first place?
Should I have quit in the first place? You know?
I think so.
Because if I would have stayed at the job, my lung condition, which is a hole in my lung, there's still a hole in my lung.
Every so often, I can feel an air bubble because
it's slowly leaking. So an air bubble slowly forms, and then,
oh, that was weird.
So the hole in my lung would have made my whole lung collapse if I would have stayed there. But me quitting and finding out what it was kind of
saved that from happening.
So me quitting saved my lung, and then if I was still working, I wouldn't have been so bored around the house, which is what influenced me to go to school. I was like, I am just sitting here doing nothing. I could, like, go do online college stuff or go to school. And my aunt, we sat down and talked, and we were like, you know what? During the contest stuff, we were just, because I was over there for 2 days, and so we just kind of talked, and I was like, you know what?
I want to go to college.
I'm not doing anything. Might as well go to college. So if I was still working, I probably wouldn't have gone to college. Or
started to go to college. I still haven't gone yet.
That's going to be a whole different beast when it comes around. Oh, heavens. And that's why I wanted to push carts, too, because that's just a simple job. You go outside, you push carts. So then I can have, because my brain's going to be overloaded from all this cool stuff, that I can just, like, relax and just push cards to one side and just chill and grab cards, bring them in, just do that kind of stuff. Not...
all that other stuff. I feel like, yeah.
Quitting the way I did was bad, just, like, up and leaving.
That was naughty. Could have, like, put in my 2 weeks or something, but... I think it was okay. It wasn't okay, but
quitting in the first place was
it helped me make good decisions. Said that 5 times now. That's it.
This video's going on long enough anyways.
We still have to...
second half of the month. This is just in the middle, so I don't... oh. I haven't really made any a lot of videos before this, so...
this is basically going to be like the only update video in this update, so it's not like I have a whole bunch of random videos throughout the whole month. I don't know what I'm gonna do, but I know this video is done.
At least this section's done. I'm going back to Wally World.
And that's it.
Sorry. To all the Babies R Us people. I'm sorry. When you put in your 2 weeks, you gotta, like, handwrite it. It's gotta be in writing that...
hey, I'm quitting in 2 weeks.
And I wrote, like, a little paragraph. About how I was sorry that I was leaving and I actually liked working there and all that kind of stuff. But
I like the people. There was a cute little paragraph. But that's it. That's it. That's it. That's it.
Get away, Ellie.
I'm gonna go. See you in the next segment, which comes right after this, which I have no idea what it is.
I have a picture to make. I'm probably going to go outside and make a picture for tomorrow, because tomorrow is Wednesday, so that's it.
Look at that. I put a piece of paper down, and what does she do?
She lays on it! Alright.
Well. Ooh, you're warm. Goodbye, and, it's been an interesting road we've been on. This past year, kind of went down, and now I'm back to where I was, pretty much. Back to the same job and all that kind of stuff. But it's not going to be the same. It's not going to be the same. That was, like, beautiful. That was beautiful. That's where you went. I can't work off of that. Hold up. Shush, Jenny Molly, don't do this again.
maybe a dozen people in there. And I think the bot, if they had a luxury box, they're probably there. It's hard to say if there's going to be fireworks.
Well, it's snowing. So I would have to imagine...
Well, there is two people in there.
The concern about the...
You only two people that went to see the game.
Like an ice rink. Second consecutive game in South Bend season where it is snowing.
Said Mother Nature is going through a divorce.
I'm going to get copyrighted if she stopped taking a video.
I don't know. His ears are twitching. He hears us.
Lay down, maybe it'll come at you.
Like before. Oh. They're doing the weird, they're doing the cute curl thing. It's so adorable.
It's like really big kitties.
He's ignoring us. Don't ignore us for too long.
Run!
Oh, she's stalking her prey. Waiting for the right moment.
There she goes! Oh my goodness, did she scare you?
Yeah. Now they're hiding.
So I put the GoPro down in there. No, now we got the whole herd. Oh dear.
Mine.
It's like a whirlpool of fish. That one's stuck! He can't get back in the water!
Hello, Doc! In the water. Yeah. It's like they have their own little swimming pool.
Oh, yeah.
There's only four out. They went even front and took the train right earlier. They sit there just bringing two out at a time, so I don't know. They were fighting with each other or what it was.
Miss Jody, this is Bree. We will be your conductor and engineer today. Oh, Bree, it doesn't sound like they want to ride the train. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Okay, that's a little better. We'll work on it.
There's only five people on the train. We are.
Bye-bye. As we leave the station here, to our left and right, you should see our giant panda. The red panda is sometimes known as the fire fox for the red fur and fox-like faces.
Fire fox, but...
Much smaller than Smiley.
The
male's name is Godzilla.
Godzilla. Godzilla. Godzilla.
That'd be cool. I would want to go with him.
Coming up on right here, we have the...
Yeah, they should.
bison. Coming up on our left, we have the Australian habitat. Inside the Australian habitat, there are wallabies, kangaroos, and emus. Wallabies look like kangaroos, except that they're much smaller, and emus are the second largest bird in the world.
Wait for it. Wait for it. Da-dun! Time to go.
That was delightful.
Chirp. Chirp again. Chirp. Because that was so cute.
It's just...
There he goes. It's such an adorable little roar.
We're playing with her. Hey, tiger! Hi, tiger! Look at me! Hi, tiger! We're tigers.
The glare is ruining it though, but they are kind of perfectly placed right there.
Bubbles.
Oh, she looked at me.
What was that? There was a noise. Poop. The power just went out. My mom was vacuuming. And the power just exploded.
What happened?
Well, your dad needs to go down and see it.
Wait.
It's the break.
No, the living room's still on.
The light's back on.
My room's not on.
These out here are on.
Which means you exploded your side of the house. Now I gotta figure out which one's which. Okay. Okay, then.
Colder.
I know. Doesn't like you. Ah, yes. Well.
I was gonna make a video right when I got off of work, but I got distracted.
Today was my last day. My last day at Pee-wee's R Us.
just thinking, what? Can I have a moment, Jedi? No, I can't. I'm just thinking about what I'm doing. Why am I doing it? Should I be doing it? Should I just stay there? The answer is no. I'll work tomorrow, and then Monday is my first, well, technically second, because I already worked one day at Lolly World, my orientation. It was after orientation when I had to do the CPLs, but they carried over from last time, so I didn't have to do any, so I just went out and pushed cards. So it technically is to be my second day. And whew, wasn't as good as I used to be. A lot of the new card guys don't know what to think about me. I came in first day, didn't talk to anybody. I said hi. And one of them came over and asked if I needed help, and I was just like, nope, I got this whole side. I'm fine, you don't have to worry about me. And that was it. So I didn't really set a good first impression. So I was kind of just testing the waters to see if I could do it. And I did. I kept the GM side spotless. The whole time. They're all worried about me coming in with a fat head acting all tough and whatnot because of what I used to do. And well, there's a reason for that. I kept the parking lot, not a single cart in the parking lot, for a whole day. I was the only one scheduled. I did need help cleaning it out, because there was a boatload out there, so they helped me get it empty. And then for the rest of the 7 hours, out there, by myself. And usually most of the time, either half of my shift or the beginning or whatever, just 4 hours out there by myself. I was always out there by myself. And I kept it perfect. That's why they hired me back. Because I actually worked. Ooh, oh snap. I'm gonna get in trouble. I wouldn't have gone back if they didn't ask. There's a reason why I don't talk. Because I'm working. If you want to talk to me, you have to talk while working. You cannot stand around and talk. You cannot stop moving. You're like a shark. You cannot stop moving. You can talk. But you have to start the conversation. I will not start a conversation. I want to work. But if you start the conversation, I will talk. That's usually how it is for most conversations with me. You gotta start it. But once you start it, they were good, and I just kinda go with it. So, work and talk. Don't stand around and talk. Work and talk. Don't get so excited, everybody. Oh, you're dying. Oh. It's really dark. Black and white makes it look really dark. I do like black and white. I don't think I've... Wait a minute. Did I... I think for like one of the bounces videos... Bounce! I think I actually made a legit video with black and white where it was set on the camera. And not... Like... During editing, I switched it to black and white. I can't remember if I actually filmed it black and white or edited it into black and white. Maybe I should actually like make a legit black and white video. But it's black and white on the camera.
Jenna Mary! Hi!
Get him, Allie. Can you hear how happy she is? Yeah, you get a good microphone. Can you hear how loud my mom's movie is? It's like 2 o'clock in the morning and she's playing a loud movie.
I need to sleep, Johnny Miley. It's hard for me to go to sleep. I don't like not knowing when something's going to happen. Like sleeping. You lay down and go to sleep. But I don't know when I'm going to fall asleep. So then I kind of lay there. Okay, when am I going to fall asleep? What am I going to dream about? What if it's a bad dream? Should I go to sleep? And I just kind of lay there. Okay, when am I going to go to sleep? Is it going to happen sometime? Like, I just kind of just lay there worrying, anticipating falling asleep. And that keeps me awake. It's complicated as it is. I should just embrace the fact that things randomly happen. One cannot know the future too much.
PlayStation's down. Gotta work fast.
Finally got it. 10 minutes. Okay, a little bit more than 10 minutes, since I'm already ready for it.
My PlayStation's hard drive full. I found this
2 terabyte hard drive. So we're gonna put it in. But first, I need to back up my stuff from the PlayStation.
Where's the remote?
There it is.
So we got to do that.
And while I'm at work, I will... It'll be updating. Oh, not updating. It'll be... Since the backup's going to take a long time, it'll be backing up, and then I'll
get on the computer, download the software, and go from there. I don't know how much is on here. I still need the computer anyway.
It's my old one. So the only thing on here should be... computer. So my...
like... backup, super latency backups of... my pictures. Let's see what's on here. Oh yeah, oh no, I moved Bootsy's father over there.
I mean, if there's more than 500 gigabytes free on this hard drive, then I don't have to worry about deleting anything. But I am going to, like, uninstall all the games or else it'll
carry those over. And I don't want to... I can just reinstall them anyways. I got them right there.
So I'm going to go through and uninstall the games that I don't have, and then it'll see how much we're at.
Alright, moment of truth.
I couldn't do anything. It's time to go to work. The alarm's going off, so... I tried this hard drive, too, and it wouldn't work. It's like, why do you make everything so complicated? Why can't stuff just work?
Anyways. So we'll go to Wally World, see if we can find a 64 gigabyte flash drive. And go from there.
Well, Wally World didn't have...
big flash drives.
There was a peg to have big flash drives, up to 128 megabytes, which is double what I actually need. But they didn't have any, so I
had to go with 32. Alright, here's the plan. This is gonna copy.
I like my videos.
I have a lot of recorded videos on here.
So, it's copying all those onto that flash drive. Stop playing with my string, gentlemen. I've decided to just put the videos on the computer so I can always have them and always watch them and always work on them because I like my gameplay videos. Hit the So when it's done, I'll put them all on here. It's only 60 gigabytes of videos altogether. So, of videos and pictures. So it won't be too bad.
Now it's downloading the update software, and then we're going to maybe she Google how to, well, take the hard drive out. I did also spend $6 on something else.
This is a tripod mount for any GoPro adapter.
Now the GoPro's got
a tripod mount for the GoPro. You just like screw it on top of a tripod, and then you screw the GoPro. You can, it's like this, but the tripod hole's going in, so it's like this, and you can put the GoPro on top. But this is the opposite way. This goes into the GoPro adapter, and then you can put you on any GoPro accessory. So let's try it out.
Okay.
This goes on to here. This goes into here. Ooh, it's a little tight.
You're on the clamp. Which means I could like clamp you anywhere I want to clamp you now.
Or use it like a selfie stick.
Huh, that works. Awesome. Alright, I'm bored, we're gonna crash cars. Well, I'm gonna crash cars, you guys are just gonna, well,
get turned off and not see anything.
Uh-oh, I got it. Is it all okay? It's all good. I still got it. Oh, we hit a bump. Which means we're flying higher than we're supposed to.
I'm fine. I should still be fine. I am. I still got this under control. I'm totally good. I got one done. One load of videos done. Got them all on the computer. Now it's copying the next step, which is again, same size. That was 17 gigabytes. Now this is... Well, no.
That wasn't 17. Yeah, that was 17? That was 17.
This is 24.
And it's been going for 30 minutes now. It still has that long. And then I got another 24 after that.
Alright, it's noon the next day. And,
I fell asleep and woke up to the PlayStation off. And I turned it on and it popped up an error message saying that it crashed.
Unplug it and take it out.
Here we go.
Okay.
Lay down. One. Come on, all the way.
All the way, come on.
There we go. Man, they make things so... Goodness. Ooh. A little dusty in there.
This is a screw. This is a screwdriver. Small!
Okay, we seriously don't have a screwdriver. So we're gonna have to improvise. Hey, the jelly bean. See if this one works. Nope. Okay. Improvise.
I think I found one. This is the one that I was looking for. I just didn't know where it was. It wasn't where it's supposed to be. Okay, me to hard drive.
Come on out. Don't be shy. How tight is this? Oh my goodness.
Kill me. Oh, wait. It's moving. It moved. Yes. Thank you. Did I strip it out? Yeah, I was getting there. Alright. There it is. Move the four little screws that surrounded the hard drive that hold it into place. So now this hard drive is free. There we go. Okay. I think that's it. Okay. I gotta set it back up so it doesn't freak out. Well, I'll plug it in. No, set it up. Okay, it's all plugged in. Let me just plug in a flash drive containing the software update. Make sure it's all in. There it goes. Now we hold down the button for 7 seconds. Was that it? Oh wait, TV's off. Hey, where's the remote? Oh. No, shut up, Johnny Valley. I did. It's connected. I didn't press the PS button, no. Oh boy. All these fancy settings. It's just reinstall system software.
How's camera died?
It died on me, but I figured out the problem. Apparently, there's more than one update file. PlayStation keeps beeping at me. Don't beep at me. Hopefully the new software will work out, I see.
And there is no user data on there. Ha ha! Well? Let's see if it worked. So much restarting. It didn't happen. Come on now. You done? That it? Are we done? We're watching a movie? Oh, I gotta
reset up all this stuff again!
Hopefully I won't have to. All I have to do is say yes, 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 turn the stuff on, okay.
Now we insert this one. insert this one. Come on. All right. Let me go to. System. Backup restart. Restart PS4. On that restart. Restart.
Get him out of here. Don't do it, Jeremiah. Don't do it. Ah, she's on me. Come on, Jeremiah. Ah! It just went blank. Oh, look at that! We're all here. Awesome sauce.
Somebody gotta sign in again. This is the eject button. That's the problem that I was having. It thinks I'm constantly pressing the eject button, but I'm not even touching it. Well, I got a whole boatload of stuff downloading and reinstalling, but I haven't gone through the disks yet.
But I kind of can't go through the disks if it's doing this.
So I've put every game in. I mean, it installs the core software instantly, and then the day one patch that every game has to have. Don't know why you can't release a game automatically finished. Begins to download, so now we shall go to downloads. And I've got a whole bunch of patches and update files downloading.
Oh, I look decent. Okay.
So, remember when I bought these lights?
I bought two more.
These were only $4. They went half price after I bought these ones. And there was two other sets, so there would have been 8. But they got bought up so fast. And now we're going to see how it looks in darkness.
Here we go, ready? Whoa.
Oh, wow. It's actually, it doesn't look too bad. Here's a big red spot on the ceiling. Now the other test I wanted to see, these would be good for slow-mo, because the only reason, the only time I can do slow-mo is outside, because it's bright enough outside all the time. So I was thinking, what if I try these for slow-mo, and then I can do it anywhere? How bright is it in slow-mo mode? So let's see. Not very bright with the red light. Let's try the other ones. Yeah, that'd be perfect. Under the right conditions, that would be perfect. Like, set some right here. Set them up. If I'm going to smash something, set them up in like a grid like this. So you like get lighting from all sides.
Oh, that look pretty. This how does it look good? This, yeah.
Now my hand hurts.
But yep, that looks good.
Cool.
I can't see with you.
Comes this one.
Is this one coming?
He's over there. He's slowly coming this way. She was coming and you scared it.
Focus now, please.
Swan. Swan.
Swan. Over there. There's a swan over there, but these ducks are very distracting. Swan.
We were showboating earlier, doing circles and stuff.
He kept helping me.
He held his one foot up on the back of his on his tail feathers there and doing
did
circles.
Did a couple circles.
And... staring at himself in the water.
Saying how sexy he looks. Man, I'm pretty. And stuff.
Man, I'm pretty. Doing lucky.
Time.
Oh, water.
He'd stick his beak in the water and go.
Watch out for the goose. We're gonna go over there and take a look at the duck. Swan.
He's coming at us.
He's coming
over here. Look how gorgeous I am. Look at me.
Creating look at me. Look at me.
Time to go.
They scared the swan.
Oh, heavens.
Those were my pictures of this one the other day.
It's not funny.
Oh, yeah, he was like right there, yep.
And then the ice cream truck came through.
The ice cream truck? Did you get ice cream?
Last year, the ice cream truck never came through. And then yesterday, it came through, but we hadn't ate dinner yet, so I didn't get the best one.
Oh.
Good reason, good reason.
All right, I'm editing this video that you're watching right now, and Johnny Molly was just growling in her sleep. I don't know if she's gonna do it again, but it was kind of weird. It makes you wonder, what does the Johnny Molly dream about? What do all creators dream about? Whoa. Must be a pretty intense dream. But it makes you wonder. We're getting deep here. We're gonna get deep. But what do they dream about? Whoa. Oh, she just lets out a big stretch and all of a sudden, ta-da! The Jelly Molly's awake. Hi, how are you doing? Were you having a hefty little dream there? Alright, I just got done with the video, so now it's time to do, well, the final video. It is the 30th today, so I need to render this video and commence uploading. What has changed? Well, you know this video? 4 hours. 4 hours. Unedited. At least I think it was. You know what? We're gonna do something risky. We're gonna save it. We're gonna hit Control A. We're gonna delete the whole video. Everything's gone. We're gonna go into the project files. And we're going to re-put everything back in. Alright. Except they just put everything in 8 minutes. Delete all this blank space. And hover over here. Oh. You know, it didn't seem that. When I was editing it, I saw three. It was at. Maybe I just like over exaggerating, I don't know. Control Z. Control Z. Control Z. Boom, we're back to normal. I guess I like to over exaggerate. It felt like 4 hours. Anyways. Oh. Well. 2 a.m. We're back into the middle of the video. That whole nighttime spiel about the last day of Baby Zara's was at 2 o'clock in the morning. Well, let's have another nighttime spiel. I didn't include the storm video. There was a storm video. And then we went to go see fireworks, but that's nothing really spectacular except it's fireworks. Plus, I recorded the fireworks at 60 frames, so I kind of want to put it in its own video. I need a park on 4th of July.
Oh.
I got all my storm videos that I don't have. Well, they're done. They're just not uploaded. And I got all those firework videos from the 4th of July for the past couple of years done. 60 frames a second, that kind of stuff. But I didn't upload those. So many things that I need to work on. Now, let's see. What topics did I cover in this video? I haven't heard anything Babies R Us anymore. They just kind of, I kind of left and that was it. A lot of the people shop at Wally World, so hopefully I'll run into them at some point. Speaking of Wally World, I've been at Wally World for 2 weeks now. My last day at Babies R Us was the 16th. So yeah, I've been there for 2 weeks. 2 weeks plus. And, it's like I never left.
Like everybody that's I've I make everybody happy. For some reason, I'm just a cheerful person. Everybody just loves to see me, and I just bring joy and happiness to everybody. Even though I'm a grumpy, on the inside, I'm a grumpy, messed up soul. But whatever. I'm happy on the outside. Anyways, I have everybody's happy. People say it's lost, just like you never left. And I kind of stuff. Like, seems like it. The only different thing is there's just a whole new set of cart people because everybody that I worked with got fired. Except for three. And then there's three new people. Four. I don't know anymore.
Yeah.
They're all happy I'm back. Everybody's just happy. It's all going good. Except for the past few days. They've been slow. You know, I like pushing carts when there's carts to push. Because once it gets past 8 o'clock on a Tuesday. Last time was Tuesday. 8 o'clock on a Tuesday. There was nobody. There was no carts. There was two people. Me and somebody else. And we just were standing there. Like, what do we do? There was no carts. That's when it gets really boring and kind of... Because there's nothing to do. Because like I said...
I like moving. I like always doing stuff. So I can't like just like... stand there and be like,
and then the second I see a cart start to go out the door, I kind of like secretly stalk behind them and wait for them to put the cart away.
Like, I grab my cart.
And then today was the same thing. There was five of us here, and it's a Thursday. Well, no, today's Friday. Thursday was actually kind of busy. It was a random busy Thursday. Today, five of us out there. In the parking lot. And it wasn't busy. It got busy towards the later half, but it came in at 1 to 3. For some reason, it was busy because everybody's still working. Nobody got off yet.
And the parking lot was empty and there was five of us here. We were just kind of like, what do we do? That's when it gets kind of ugh.
And of course, every day, I get to be a door greeter too. I gotta cover somebody's break or somebody's lunch. Those are delightful times. I totally loved doing that back in the day. Yeah. I totally came back to be a door greeter. Other than those little itty bitty things, which were the same things that annoyed me back in the day, it's all good.
Everybody loves me. All the cart people finally warmed up to me. It took a little bit because they were scared of me. But, they like me
because I actually work. Mm-hmm. Because they like to talk to my mom too, because she used to be the door greeter and they always talk to her about me. But now she's a manager, so they don't really get to see her anymore. But every time she's on lunch, they chat away about me or other things, but it's usually about me. And she comes home and says, "Oh, they just love you over there," and all that kind of stuff, because they like me. They like working with me, because like I said, I'm a cheerful, happy person, and I make everybody happy. So everybody just kind of flocks around me, because I'm just a happy, cheerful person.
And I actually work. I'm a happy, cheerful person that actually works. People get, they trust me. It's all just wonderful. Are you recording? Okay, I had to make sure you're recording.
Ever since I got back, I've noticed, like my first couple days I was there, could see why they wanted me to come back, because a few of y'all, to the car people, a few of y'all just like,
work, please. Actually push carts, please.
But ever since I came back, I've noticed a change, and everybody else has noticed a change.
Like, they're starting to work more because I'm actually showing them how it's done.
Even one of the cart people said that I'm making them look bad because I work too much. It's not, well, it is because I am pushing too many carts.
I'm starting doing that again. I can't help it. I like to make sure the job gets done.
But half the time I just push and done carts, but I do it quick.
Like, I went to lunch one time. This was like 3 days ago. No, not 3 days ago.
It was just a little bit ago. I went to lunch for an hour. And of course I was the only one there. Well, it was just me and somebody else on the other end. So, and that the other guy likes to stay on the other end and he doesn't come over on this side unless there's no carts. When it gets so slow that he comes on to the grocery side where I usually am, that's when you know it's a slow day. But he usually stays over there on the gym side. And I went to lunch, so my side got backed up. And one of the door greeters, he likes to come out and help when there's more than one door greeter. So he likes to come out and help me push in carts. And 5 minutes. I came back from lunch. He said that he'll be all right on out to help me pick up some carts. 5 minutes. He came out, went to one corral, got a little bit, and then looked around and noticed everything was all picked up. I cleared the whole side in 5 minutes. He looked at me and like, see what happens when you hustle? And I was like, yep, I know.
This is how it usually happens. This is how it should be, people. Work. I'm just rambling right now, sorry. That's what happens before I go to sleep. I ramble, but now it's in video form. But yeah, so new job, working out fine. I like it. Now, anything else?
I haven't talked about the websites, have I?
I haven't done a site update in a while. Because, well, I haven't worked on the websites because of the new job and getting school set up. School! Oh, school!
I got a letter. I don't know where it went, but I got a letter in the mail showing my financial stuff. Like, how much school is exactly going to cost, and how much financial aid that I'm going to get. And the financial aid doubled how much it cost. Like, I'm going to have a lot of extra financial aid money, which is a good thing. So I can use it for projects and whatnot. Like, if they want me to do like a photo project and I need a studio, I could like rent a studio, that kind of stuff. But I don't really do studios. I can either make one at home or just take it for yourself outside. Or need like materials for props and whatnot. Because I'm pretty sure I'll have something like that where they would require
props and stuff, and ugh. I don't do that kind of stuff. I can, but I don't need that kind of stuff to tell a story with my pictures. Anyways. I'm more of a nature photography kind of guy.
Alright. Yeah, so school is slowly getting settled in. It's all working. And if I actually lived at school for like board and transportation and all that kind of stuff,
it would be an extra $5,000.
Which means I would actually owe the school money. Because that would go over the financial aid by a lot. So, yeah. It's a good thing I'm not living there. And I need to sit down, figure out a schedule, so that in June or July, because school starts in August, sit down with one of my managers at the Wally World and be like, hey, I'm starting school soon. I'm going to have to cut back my hours, which is why I haven't been pushing full time. I want to be full-time. But then I would just have to cut full-time and go back to part-time and anyways. Because I just have to go to school. I can only work 20 hours. So I had to figure out, when should I work? What days? Oh, you're tired. What days are for work and what days are for school? Like homework and whatnot. See what I'm saying? So, are you? Oh, so, yeah. So I figured we're figuring it out. I could, one of the school days I'm going 9 to 3, so I got 2 classes, full day of school, and then other days are 9 to 12, I think. 9 to 12 and then 12 to 3. Those are 2 classes. And then I have one that's just 9 to 12, either it's just 9 to 12 or just 12 to 3. I can't remember. So I could work on one of those half days, or I could work on one of the full days and work a night shift. But then I don't know if I would want to work, because I would be exploded from school and I kind of want to calm down. And most of the classes at school are the photography and computer classes, obviously, because you need a computer lab and whatnot. And the English and the math and stuff are all online. I can just
do that here.
So, yeah. I was hoping to have everything be online. That would be so much easier if everything was just online. But no! Hopefully I don't fail. Especially English. I'm worried about the math in English because I didn't do so well in English. I can speak English just fine. I don't need to take a class on English. Okay, so I went on a tangent and talked about school. School's even more settled in. I got approved, got the money. Well, I didn't get the money, but it showed me how much I'm gonna get and how much it's gonna cost. I still haven't got the money yet. Work's doing fine. I was gonna talk about the websites, but there's nothing really to talk about because I haven't had time to work on it because I've just been with doing other stuff. And I can't really find anything new to do on the websites. I am testing some things, but that'll be for later, probably. Because it's been 2 months since I did an update. There's nothing new to do. I can't find anything new to add, and I don't have time to work on anything. Oh, sorry, websites. And what else? Well, that's pretty much it. What are the topic? Like, my mouse is frozen. What are the topics covered in the video? Did I update everything that has happened in the video? Yes, there's the video. Okay. So yeah. That's just about it. Sorry this video was long, but
it was a hefty update. There was a lot of stuff going on in here. So
we'll see what the next month holds.
Alright.
So, see you next month, and,